All right, if I don't make this claim up front, I'm going to have the typical idiots, claiming I'm strawmanning them. This is not going to be a video debating those people who say that advertising can be manipulative. Advertising can be manipulative, right? They use those brain scans. We all know they use those color combinations and all this other stuff and subliminal bullshit in order to get you to buy things. This is not really debating that. What this is debating is the claim that people are forced into making economic decisions that they wouldn't otherwise because they're being forced through advertising techniques. Now, these advertising techniques only work on the margins, right? You have to be someone who is already in the market for these kinds of goods, right? Because there's no amount of advertising that's making me want to buy a box of tampons, right? Because I have no need for them. You know, I don't have the necessary equipment in order to benefit from buying a box of tampons. And these companies that make them, like Johnson & Johnson, right? Like Unilever, they use all these manipulative techniques when they're making their videos or their advertisement videos and pages in magazines to manipulate me into buying their brand of tampons. But the problem is I have no use for them, right? Just like I have no use for a case of Mountain Dew, okay? It tastes like ass to me. So no amount of advertising that Pepsi or Unilever or even Trojan for their brand new fucking line of sex toys, right, would ever compel me to buy something that I have no interest in buying, okay? You can make all the advertisements you want. I'm not going to drink a case of Mountain Dew. It also breaks down when you just think about, if you just think about it for like 5 minutes, right, all this shit breaks down. If no company would ever go out of business. If all these were true, all you would ever have to do, if you were a businessman, to prevent yourself from going out of business is just invest in more advertising. You'd be forcing people to go out and buy your product, and you'd be making $1 million, right? So all these companies that we keep seeing, you know, disappearing would never go out of business, ever. Because the only thing they would have to do is just go to Madison Avenue and say, hey, man, fucking hook some people up to some brain scan things and fucking make us a new video, right? That's all you have to do. In fact, they wouldn't even have to do that because all that science is already available, open to the public. We all know about it. We all have seen the videos on how to do it. It just fucking doesn't make any sense. It would also mean that no one would ever save money because as soon as they come in contact with any form of advertising that uses these techniques, they would go and spend all their money on this stuff, right? That no one would ever save any money. Everyone would be bankrupt every year. Every time you go into a mall, you could not help but go and buy that fucking brand new prom dress, even though, you know, you don't wear dresses or it's not even prom or whatever. Right, because they're using all these techniques. It doesn't make any sense for people to make this claim, but people do regularly. So my challenge, if you really do believe that these advertisements forces people to buy things that they would never buy, ever buy, through any other means, then make me, using all this science that's freely available, you know, in all the journals and all the newspapers and all the internet documentaries, right? Use all these techniques and provide me a video that you make or someone else can make it for you. I don't care. That would make me buy a box of tampons. And until that day, shut the fuck up.